Hello, I'm Vijay Mahajan, and I work in the field of promoting livelihoods for low-income households, mainly rural. I've done this for 35 years, first 10 years with an organization called Pradhan, and then another 25 years with another organization called Basics.
My first question to you is, what's that one thing you really care about that drives all your action in this space of livelihood?
Well, what bothers me a lot is that there is an enormous amount of absolute poverty. I mean, I don't mind some inequality in society. I think that's but natural. But such a large number of people living below humanly acceptable standards is not acceptable, particularly when we have the resources, we have the knowledge, we have the institutions today to easily address those issues. So I've translated that in terms of poverty alleviation, but to do something positive to promote livelihoods, and that's what I care about deeply.
It's a very tough space to work in. What are the challenges you faced?
Well, initially my belief was that since India has a large banking system which is socially oriented, it was nationalized in 1969, and then it was given a mandate to lend to the poor, there's a priority sector obligation on all banks, and there are a large number of rural branches. So I'd assumed that the capital for individual household development would come from banks, and that we, the development people, what we have to do is organize the poor, help them with identifying appropriate activities, or maybe run some test pilots, and then get the bank loans, start the activity, handhold, and link them with markets, and then move on to the next one. And we did this quite successfully using grants, mainly donor grants, while I was in Pradhan. We were not greatly successful at that stage in raising bank loans. So I then felt that if the idea has to be scaled up, we need to use mainstream credit. And since we found it impossible to raise loans from banks, I decided in 1993 to set up a bank for the poor, which eventually became Basics in 1996. So since then, of course, we've started, in a sense, we seeded a whole industry which is known as the microfinance industry, due to which today something like 1 lakh crore of rupees flow to the poor, which wouldn't have happened but for these 20 years of effort. And Basics is just a tiny player, so we've helped trigger a whole industry. The fact is that while 1 lakh crores is very satisfying, it's not even 0.5% of the total bank credit. So we still have a long way to go. And now there are other challenges. For example, markets are not easy. Markets on the input side as well as output linkages are not easy. They're full of vested interests, monopolies, or at least oligopolies. There are issues of regulation which are not exactly pro-poor. There are many, many other bottlenecks. So one has to actually work on the entire value chain, and that requires a skill set which is rarely available with one individual or even often with one organization. So over the years, we've learned to collaborate across sectoral boundaries with various types of organizations to be more effective. Within the Basics group itself, we have 12 different entities, but that's not enough. So we have to go across to other organizations.
You spoke about collaboration. Could you elaborate that as an insight while you were implementing your microfinance programs?
Take something as simple as, say, growing soybean, helping small and marginal farmers grow soybean and make a living out of it. So you just start from getting good quality seed, which may require working with the National Center, Research Center on Soybean and Indore. You may require good quality rhizobium culture, so you need an input supplier for that. Then, of course, you need to organize the farmers, train them, etc. And then once they actually have the output, then, they can't just take it to the mandi and get a low price. So you've got to have output buyers who will, give a good price. So you're talking of several linkages, none of which are within your own ambit. And so in any value chain that you work, you typically have to deal with one input supplier, one credit provider, sometimes an insurance company, definitely one or two output buyers, and often a regulatory agency. So one needs to learn to collaborate. And remember, none of this is our own farms. We are not producing anything. We are just helping farmers to do this. So.
So okay, now coming back to GAP, how has your experience been?
Well, given that it's a first time ever event, I thought it was very well done. And as I said on the first day, the Stan Kal Patra was very special. I already said this to Sunil that the proof of the pudding is in the follow-up. In a sense, GAP has just begun from tomorrow. It's what follow-up actions people take. After the event, there's always a sense of aha and a lot of charge and, feeling a sense of camaraderie and part of a larger movement. But when people go back, they are again lonely, they again need inputs, they again need guidance. So I think a strong support network needs to be built, and that is what will distinguish GAP from several similar efforts.
What do you think of the spirit, like they keep talking about collaboration, working together. What do you think of that theme? Do you think it's a theme that would work for, say, an Indian scenario?
I think so, and we need to learn more to collaborate in India. We've sort of grown up in a shortage economy, so our tendency is to sort of grab whatever we have and not share it with the others. I'm talking about the last 50 years. Before that, we had a sharing culture because we were a land of plenty. So I think as we are again becoming a land of plenty in some ways, the sharing culture needs to come back and collaboration should come back. So.
What do you think of, the theme is global action on poverty. What is it, that one thing that is going to unlock the potential of actually rejecting and weeding out absolute poverty?
Quite honestly, we should stop looking for one magic bullet. We should look for 1,000 flowers bloom, and as a large number of fireflies, as Arun Mehra said. That is, I think, what is more important. I'm quite suspicious of single magic bullet type of solutions because they can be very totalitarian and, in the long run, can damage the interests of the really poor.